What's up, everybody? This is Mommy Wata. I'm back because two things. First of all, something happened on Friday. Someone received a heavy dose of karma on Friday. And we're just back in this space of, instead of taking personal responsibility and accepting their karma and trying to move forward with their life, they're playing the blame game. They still have this vendetta to try to hurt and ruin someone else's life. And they're still doing black magic. I hate to say it. And the reason why I am making this reading about it is because if you watch my videos, I've been saying for probably about a month or two now, I received a download that if someone didn't stop doing all this black magic, that they were going to be dead in 3 months. And so I'm just going to say it flat out now, because I've tried to say it in other ways and people just obviously are not taking the warnings. Because if I'm picking up on this energy, it's someone who watches my content. Somehow this person is in my energy. So if they're still doing this, they have not learned the lesson. And I'm telling y'all that whoever this is that continues to do black magic against others, whoever it is, that they just will not give up this relentless fight and are still spiritually attacking people, they will be dead by January. Because this January was the third month, okay? And, you know, I'm going to put trigger warning at the beginning of this video because I don't like to talk about death. I don't like premonitions about death, but this person just refuses to do the right thing. This person is constantly trying to spiritually attack other people. And something happened Friday in this person's life that was like really a major tower moment. Okay, that's what I'm picking up on. So it's like they are just in revenge mode. And last night, they were back at it again, y'all. I was going to use this Hoodoo Tarot deck to try to see what was going on, but I'm just going to use this other deck that I just got. This will be my first reading with it, but I have been working with it, but we're going to see what comes out with this new deck. Holy Spirit, what messages do you have for us regarding this person who will not stop doing black magic? What is going to happen with this person if they don't stop? We know that their attacks aren't going to work. They're just irritating at best. But it's actually having a very negative effect on their life and their livelihood and their existence in this world. So what's going to happen to this person if they don't stop doing this black magic, Holy Spirit? What is going to be their fate? Let's go. Messages. We have the Ace of Cups. Okay. Slide this over because I want to make sure everybody can see this. What else? We have the Two of Swords here. Somebody is still trying to block someone from having their blessings, their abundance, their overflowing cup of energy and happiness and all that good shit, okay, that God has for that person. You know, their life, their Akashic records. This person is trying to block this person, period. We have the Moon on the bottom. This person is trying to manipulate this other person's life still using black magic. We have the Six of Pentacles on the bottom. Heavy manipulation is going on here. This person is trying to have this other energy down on their knees somewhere. Needing scraps. Having to beg people for help. Just in this bad, destitute state, okay? It's this Queen of Wands. We have a Queen of Wands out here now. It's the same Queen of Wands energy that I've been picking up on that is just, you know, I don't know what the fuck wrong with this person at this point. I can't keep making excuses for them. I can't keep trying to rationalize their behavior, okay, that keeps coming out in these readings and stuff. But this person is going to be in a Ten of Swords. I'm telling y'all, this person is going to be dead by January because they will not stop with the black magic. It's just cut and dry. They are bound. We have the Eight of Swords here. These are brand new cards. Y'all ain't never seen me do a reading with these cards before. But look how this shit coming out. I ain't even had to deal out anything. It's literally coming out on its own, okay? We have the Eight of Swords now. This person is bound to this mission that they're on, okay, to create havoc and ruin this person's life. They are just, it's like it is an obsession for them. But they are being judged for it. They're being judged right now for it with this judgment card here. They're already receiving judgment for trying to spiritually attack this energy. This Queen of Wands is already under judgment. She already going through it, but she won't stop, y'all. It's sad. It's very sad. She will not stop. She refuses with this Four of Pentacles to let this fight go. She's holding on so hard to this fight. I mean, I don't know what you call it. It literally is an obsession. It's giving me single white female movie vibes, okay? Because it's almost like I can't be this person. I can't step into their skin. I'm picking up this Queen of Wands has tried to copycat this person, has tried to do spell work to literally take over this person's body, mind, and spirit to be this person. And I feel like it may have been working for a while, this copycat spell, this mirroring energy that I'm picking up on. But she can't be like her no more. And it's killing her that she can't naturally be like this woman. So she would rather try to ruin this woman and take this woman off the face of the earth, y'all. This is sad. Then just do what she needs to do to move forward and be the best woman she can be in her life. What else, Holy Spirit? What else? We have the Ace of Pentacles. I'm telling y'all, God has really stepped in on this situation. He stepped in a while ago. He stepped in. He really tightened up on this Queen of Wands energy days ago, okay? I'm telling you, this Queen of Wands experienced some heavy form of judgment on Friday. And so she's like, this weekend, I'm gonna make some shit shake because she is facing more judgment, more towers on Monday. She knows, and this is, I don't know what it is that she's going through particularly, but she already knows her ass is gonna be back in the hot seat again on Monday. So it's like this desperate attempt to try to keep this woman in, and I'm saying woman now. So this Queen of Wands is attacking a woman. That's the same thing I've been picking up on. She has a vendetta against a particular feminine energy. And she is trying to take this person out the game. But this person is spiritually protected with this Ace of Pentacles here. This person is a divine being. This is why this Queen of Wands is going through it. Because she's trying to spiritually attack one of God's chosen people. One of God's earth angels. And she is not getting it that this person is divinely protected. And she gonna kill herself trying to take this woman out. This Queen of Wands is gonna end her life trying to mess with this divine creature who has been abundantly blessed by the universe. Okay? Any final messages, Holy Spirit? Because we already know what time it is. It ain't no need to keep staying here. We have the Eight of Cups here. Like I said, she's still working at it. Y'all see how that flew out? She's not going to stop. So it's like no need to keep giving her energy by showing the shit that she's doing. Just know that this Empress that you keep trying to work so hard to attack here, okay? Because you're mad about whatever relationships and energy that this has been brought into this woman world, because I'm telling y'all, I been have picked up also that this bullshit is about a man. This bullshit started about a man. And I also was picking up in my other reading that the man is the one who put this Queen of Wands onto this Empress because he knew who she was. He started this shit, okay? So this Two of Cups right here is just more reminder to this Empress, if you're listening, this Queen of Wands, if you're listening, and this other female masculine energy who got all this shit going, God knows that you played a part in all of this with this Two of Cups here. Even though you're not out here on this board, masculine energy, God knows that you played a heavy hand in this Queen of Wands obsession with this Empress and trying to destroy her. Okay? God know. We have the Two of Pentacles right here. This guy, that got spell work written all over it. She tried to keep an ongoing cycle, an infinite cycle of chaos and confusion rolling in this Empress's life. But what's happening is everything that she's doing or has tried to do, the boomerang effect has brought that shit right back to her with this infinity symbol here. That's all I see. Any final messages, Holy Spirit? Any final messages about this energy? We have the Devil. Child, y'all gonna start listening to me one day. Y'all gonna come back and be like, damn, now you said that? Damn. You somebody, y'all gonna see? Y'all gonna see. Look at that Devil card. There she go right there. Just can't get enough. She is bound by the Devil, y'all. Anything else? Page of Cups. Like I said, homegirl was up last night working on a spell to drop down on top of this Empress's head. I love imagery. I love how I can see things through pictures. I'm visual. I can see things through cards. If you can look, I hope y'all can see this. This Page of Cups, if you, I'm going to hold it up because this is it right here on this reading for me. On this Page of Cups, he looking down. He got a cup in his hand. A Page of Cups is some type of offer, some type of gesture, something that you're offering someone. If you look at this Page of Cups, he looking straight down where this card was at. He was looking straight down at this Empress right here, okay? And the Devil right there. This woman, I'm telling y'all, this woman was back at it last night, but it's okay. It's all right. It's going to be all right. You know why? Because she has already been warned. And she don't want to believe the promises that God got for her. And she about this doing this black magic. And she don't want to believe that he is going to put a death to this situation one way or the other. That's on her. Okay? I'm not pulling no more energy on this bullshit because I'm tired of this. But you got to let people learn the hard way. You have to let people learn the hard way. They don't want to stop. They don't want to listen to nobody. They don't want to look at their own lives and see how what they are doing is causing them to be destroyed inside and out. Then you just going to have to let them do what they do, child, and let them end up with the fate that they're going to end up in. This is the last warning that I'm doing to this, about this Queen of Wands energy, this witch who is jealous of this Empress because of whoever she used to date that this Queen of Wands was connected to. And she has went on a relentless mission to try to destroy this Empress's life. This Empress has come out on this table in like the last three readings or so that I've done in regards to this energy, this black magic situation. But this is the last reading that I'm going to do on it because I know this Empress is good. This Empress is sitting on stacks probably. This is what I'm picking up now. You trying to do all this to this woman. But this woman is so protected, so blessed. She got money. Her family good. Her love life is good. I'm picking up. She's practicing self-love, if nothing else. She is abundant. She has a lot of good things ahead of her that she's about to walk into. You can't do shit to affect this woman's life. All you're doing is affecting your own life. And really, you know, I hate to say it, but you're digging your own grave. You really are. So, again, this is my last time I'm doing any public readings on this witch here. Ain't nobody got time for this shit no more. We moving on. We elevating. If it come out and I feel like it's a warning my collective needs to hear, I may post something about it. But this is going to be, hopefully, my last reading about this Queen of Wands energy and the witch shit that she been doing against this Empress. Because it's going to be over by January. Okay? This is going to be over very soon. So, I hope who needs to hear this message gets the warning. I hope this enlightens somebody and brings them some clarification about what will happen to your life if you play with black magic. And I'll be back soon with another one, y'all. And also remember, if this don't apply, let it fly. But you know what you've been doing behind closed doors and in the dark. So if this is your life, you better let it apply and you better start making some changes or you're going to see your maker. And that's all I got to say. I'll holler at y'all. Peace.